Now, another very common animal dewormer, and it's not Panacure or Fenbendazole, it's also being studied as a treatment for cancer. I encourage you to sign up for my new free webinar, What You Need to Know About Omega-3 Supplements for Dogs and Cats. You can click the link in the box below to sign up. Really? Another animal dewormer, this time Ivermectin. The actual name of the drug is Ivermectin, as a treatment for cancer. First, I have to thank one of you guys, a subscriber, asked me questions and suggested this. I'm like, really? I don't know. Sure enough, it's actually been studied. And many of these scientists are considering a real legitimate new treatment for cancer. The paper is titled Ivermectin, a potential anti-cancer drug derived from an antiparasitic drug. Ivermectin, it's long been used in veterinary medicine as a very safe and very effective antiparasitic drug. You know, I remember growing up on the farm, I mean, that was just a few years ago. And what did we use to deworm our sheep? We used Ivermectin Drench. It's being studied and used for people, for scabies, river blindness, even being used for lice. Recently, it's been reported that ivermectin has been reported to inhibit multiple tumor cells by the regulation of multiple signaling pathways. Because of that, the authors state that ivermectin may be an anti-cancer drug with great potential. Here are four key highlights from the paper. One, they found that ivermectin effectively suppresses the growth and spread of cancer cells, promotes cancer cell death, and is non-toxic to healthy cells. And number two, they found that ivermectin shows excellent efficacy against chemotherapy-resistant cancer cells. And number three, they found that the ivermectin, it can be combined with the chemotherapy, showing to even be more beneficial and effective against fighting some of these cancers. Then number four, they were able to isolate how ivermectin is actually working against these cancer cells. It's affecting a thing called PAK1 kinase, and that is specifically how the ivermectin, it regulates the multiple signaling pathways. So does this mean there's like a now another new anti-cancer drug, you know, potentially effective for our dogs and cats? And I'm not gonna speak to people, but it, you know, it seems like it. If any of my animals were to have cancer, I'll tell you, I'm pretty open to trying a whole array of different alternative options. You know, knock on wood, you know, if I were to get some nasty, you know, cancer, darn right, I'd be trying some of these alternative options. There's no discussion in terms of specific doses and or specific regimens, but we can discuss sort of what the typical deworming regimen is, say for a dog or cat, if they're being treated with ivermectin. The standard ivermectin dose for animals, say we're treating a dog with scabies at sarcoptic mange, it's 0.1 milligrams per kilo. So a little Tula, she's 20 pounds, about 10 kilos. She'd be getting 0.1 mg per kilo times 10, which equates to 1 milligram of ivermectin. This is the injectable Ivermac, it's 10 milligrams per mil. Tula's dose is that amount, 0.1 cc, which is 1 milligram. And if she were being treated for something such as sarcoptic mange, I'd be giving her the 0.1 cc just under her skin, it's sub-Q. Ivermac for cancer, I think it's a real option. As this study progresses and as more studies come out, I'm definitely going to share more information with you. More particular, is it being used for animals for cancer? At what dose? At what regimen? And often, like, what are the results? Is it safe and is it effective? And if that's the case, awesome news. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you found it helpful. At the very least, I'd love for you to give a thumbs up to this video and share it with your friends. It's Dr. Jones. Last but not least, I encourage you to sign up for my new free webinar, What You Need to Know About Omega-3 Supplements for Dogs and Cats. You can click the link in the box below to sign up.